Hello friends, my name is Dan and welcome to American Truck Simulator. I didn't thought I would talk in any of these videos ever, but hey, why not give it a try, talk about life a bit, you know, what's going on, what's been happening, world, in your life maybe, if you leave a comment, could talk about that too, a little in my life, oh, never mind. In my life is going on misshifting. So I loaded everything already. We're off to the races and we're carrying tarped plywood. So I'm gonna bring that. I think it was 100-odd miles away. I'm too lazy to pick up the navigation. Oh, that one is a tricky one here. I've picked up stuff here before. That turn is quite a turn. Yeah, what's been going on in my life? Not much, to be honest. It's been a rather boring couple of years, so to say. If you're new here and you don't know who I am, I started this channel a long time ago with Battlefield, a very long time ago. I think it was 2014. I started the whole thing with Battlefield. Don't mind me. I'm misshifting. I'm doing a lot of things still wrong. I'm still new to all of this, so yeah. Yeah, I started the channel 2014 ago. 2014 ago in 2014. I'm doing this all in one take, so bear with me. There's no cuts or edits unless I need to take a screenshot for the thumbnail. Then I will tell you though. Yeah, it's been a long time. I switched then in between to War Thunder, which was a blessing for my channel because it gave it quite a good boost, to be honest. I think in a span of 2 months I broke over 1500 subs. Which speaks for itself, wasn't too bad. I mean, there's other channels obviously that make 1 million in that month, but it's not me. I'm just a little Dan driving a tank on a virtual battlefield, and then on top of that it was arcade. So yeah, if you don't know what is War Thunder, it's a game with planes and tanks, and it's relatively towards the realism side of things. Even in arcade, I found it pretty. The damage model was pretty decent. Nothing compared to, like, for example, if you wish like World of Tanks with HP bars and stuff, it was nothing like this. It was just the raw tank model. So if you hit something, and the shell was big enough, it's gonna do more than enough damage. Oh, I thought we don't make that. So yeah. As you can see, I don't know if you noticed, but I can't see the streetlights. So if I switch to the outside view, it's because I can't see the streetlights. I'm sitting too high, but I don't want to go any lower. Then I feel like a little child looking over, trying to look over. And since I don't have a track IR, and I'm doing everything with shortcuts, since I don't want to move my mouse while I'm playing. Yeah, it's a bit awkward. So yeah, War Thunder. That was that. I got burned out from War Thunder, not only from War Thunder. It's a long story. If you wanna know a bit more about that story, there's I can put a video in the video description of this video, and you can click that or in the comment section where I explain a bit of what happened during that time. You know, I won't go through all of that again now. It's a really long story, which I kept short already in that video. And yeah, I mean. That is a problem. What happened up there? What the hell? So yeah, I got burned out from War Thunder and from life overall. We moved to a new city. Things have changed in my life completely from positive to absolutely horrible. And yeah, I stopped doing YouTube, to be honest. I got sick of all of it. The upkeep with content and stuff like this, the newest of the newest, you have to do this, you have to do that, and dear lord, it was horrible. to be honest. I don't understand. I mean, my biggest problem is that I'm having ADHD, so sticking that long to War Thunder as I did back then was crazy. I mean, I still play Counter-Strike to this day, so that's also really weird. I don't know how that is working. But sticking to one game or to one thing for so long is pretty hard for me. And I have to tell my buddy, hey, do it, listener. Oh god, engine brake on this one. Kriegbaum, make it more quiet. Or more gentle at higher RPMs. I don't know what happened. It's quite loud. So I moved on from YouTube. Relaxed, to be honest. I did nothing for 2.5-3 years now. And now I'm starting again. I want to get back into the groove. I found a game that actually relaxes me, where I don't have to try hard, where I don't have to do anything. I just sit down, take my wheel, my shifter, go out on the wide road, take a good-looking truck, customize it to my needs, take an engine that I want in it, and just drive around. You know? And that's why I'm posting these videos. Even when the reason why I don't talk in these videos, and this is not gonna be a permanent thing now, what I'm doing. This is gonna be a weekly occasion, maybe a monthly occasion, I haven't decided yet. We'll figure that out together. And I will see how the retention is on these videos when I'm talking. So the reason why I don't talk on these videos is because it's relaxing, you know? It's just relaxing to listen to the sound of the engine, just going along on the street. Maybe there's some rain. The rain can relax you. You can leave the phone on or the video on while you're falling asleep, you know, just to listen to this monotone engine sound or the rain. That makes it super, for me, super relaxing, honestly. I can listen to that stuff all night. Even to my own videos. I watch my own videos just to relax a little sometimes when I don't feel like I wanna play the game directly. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. That's where we're at right now. I still play other games in between. I like to play MMOs. I play a lot of Valorant at the moment, some Apex Legends. Completely different story from what I'm doing right now. So yeah, there's that. What games are you playing on the side? Tell me. I'm curious. Are you only playing simulator games? Or are you also doing shooter games or MMOs like I do? To keep the head busy, to keep a little fresh in the head, you know? Because as nice as all of this here is, I still need that action part. I'm 34 years old, I have played shooter games since I can remember, since I got my first PlayStation 1, I think, back in the day, and I was like 9 years old, and my cousin came by with a cracked PlayStation, you know, you know how it is, and he brought Resident Evil, and I was hooked. I was scared shitless, but I was hooked. So yeah, and then I Counter-Strike when I was like 13, I saw it the first time in an internet coffee, you know, where you just gather and actually play the games, and yeah, that's how Counter-Strike started, man, the shooter games. That was... And I'm still hooked. I'm 34, I still play, I still thrive to improve in them, for whatever reason. I mean, I'm 34, it doesn't matter at this point anymore, right? But I'm chilling in them with friends a lot, and so on, but still, I still like to improve and stuff, so... Oh, shizzles. Oh, we barely missed that. Always, every time I go over these, the train passes by. And yeah. And so I'm trying to improve in American Truck Simulator even. I had a wheel without a shifter, so I was playing automatic gearbox for quite a while. And I switched to the 18 speed when I realized the automatic gearbox is zero challenge to me, so I need a bit of engagement while driving, you know, just pressing gas and brake is... it's nice for a change sometimes, but it's also nice to be engaged in something that you like and that you enjoy. So for me it was doing this. It's just awkward for me to turn right now because my microphone is in the way of my hand, because I'm having a microphone arm right in front of me as we speak. So if you see some weird wiggle turns like this, don't mind. Yeah, so I bought the shifter, learned the 18 speed, put the button on the wheel for a low and high. I don't have a like one of these custom shifters where you can switch like in the real truck the range of the gear. I don't have that. I'm just doing it on the wheel, but that's why I can't switch the gear sometimes, and I just over rev the engine because just in a turn and I forget which button was it to press, and yeah, it gets a mess. If you see me driving, you're gonna be like, oh my god. So, and yeah, and also on top of that, I don't have a driver license in real life, so that doesn't make it easier for me either. I have to learn. I knew how to clutch shift before. I have driven a car in real life already. On safe roads, obviously, on closed roads or closed places. But yeah, I know how it works. It's not my first time driving a car. But the biggest problem for me is that there's so many ways of shifting this. And then the floating the gears. I can float gears pretty okay. When I have to shift upwards the gears, or like up to the gears, but when I have to shift down, I have no idea how to rev match and how to float the gears that way. I have to still figure this out. I watched a tutorial on it and I'm completely lost. I have no idea. I have zero idea. Oh man, we quite missed that by a mark, and that guy is tailgating me till the limit. So yeah. Oh yeah, we're driving a beautiful W900, I forgot to tell you that. I drive that truck so much right now. I don't know if you hear these. The shifting sounds and all other little nuances in this truck in terms of sound. I'm a sound guy. I used to DJ back in the day and I love sound. So all of this that Z-Mod put it into these sounds that came that you can buy on his homepage. I hate driving other trucks. I don't like to say it, but honestly, it became, oh shit, we're going a bit fast. Gotta brake a little. It became, yeah, it's okay. I'm braking. It became a pain in the ass for me to drive other trucks without interior sounds and good engine sound. This engine sound now is from Kriechbaum. You probably know him already. He's been an old dog in the ATS scene, as I have seen. He's been there for a while and a sound guy. His sounds are good, but Z-Mod brought all of this to a whole nother level, in my opinion. Like the stuff that he does to get the sounds is freaking insane and amazing. I love it. I buy any sound that he brings out. I buy the sounds before I even consider buying a truck mod, to be honest. Like I'm not a guy that has a lot of money, so I usually just buy what I can. And in that case, for example, it's the truck sounds. As you can see, I'm driving a stock. It's the SCS W900, the default one. I mean, you can see by the air filter is not modeled nicely, to say the least, in terms of detailing in the mesh. But yeah, I don't have the money to buy trucks, expensive trucks or anything like this, so I just drive the default ones with the upgraded interior mod, and that's about it. Yeah. Do you buy trucks? Do you buy a lot of trucks? I'm curious. Because, see, I can't shift right now. Because now I don't know if I'm in low gear. Oh yeah, I am in low gear. Okay, perfect. So let's go in the outside view, because parking made easier like this. And I'm hitting my microphone as we speak, and I think I won't make that turn. Yeah, I definitely won't make that turn. Need to take my time. forgot to put on my hazards as a noob. As a novice I am. And I could skip the parking now, but I'm gonna try to do it myself. I hope my voice came over correctly in this video, so you guys can enjoy or not enjoy that. Oh yeah, we nailed that one first try. No problem. There we go. I'm still learning to park. Like, I'm still learning the whole thing, all of it. It's quite a tall task. I mean, I've never driven a truck or a car in my life before, so all of this is quite new to me. So yeah, that's about it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this. I'm gonna call this Drive and Talk. So if you want more of this, you can obviously leave a comment and tell me that, and leave a comment about all the other things I ask you in between in the video. Maybe make it in one comment. Leave a like, and if you want to see more of this, subscribe. Have a good one, guys. Thanks for watching. Bye.